Welcome again to Jeddah Economic Forum sessions. As we have mentioned, this session will be entitled Al Masfaq. Please allow me to introduce with pride the person who is going to present the paper. Our guest was born in Taif City in 1941. He grew up in the holy city of Makkah.
He received the BA in commerce from the University of Riyadh.
He worked as a financial representative at the Ministry of Trade and Commerce, after which he became a consultant at the Ministry of Finance. Thereafter, he left the government,
established
his own enterprise in the early 1960s, and in the early 80s, he established Al-Baraka Investment and Development Company, which brought together under its umbrella several banks and financial institutions, which work according to Sharia law in transactions, and other companies which exercise different and various activities all over the world, especially in the Islamic States. His companies are considered to be pioneers in Islamic economics, and he is considered to be one of the pioneers of Islamic economics. He established for that purpose research chairs and centers which carry his name in different universities. He is known for his copious writing, copious writings in different areas of Islamic economy. Economics. He received many awards, including the IDB award in the area of Islamic banking in 1995. Then Banker of the Year, Union Arab of Arab Banks in 1996, and other awards, such as the Life Harvest in 1996, from Ernest & Young, and the Gulf Businessman Award in 1994, and also the award of the American Finance Foundation in 1994, and Award for Services, and other many awards. I know for sure that Sheikh Saleh wants me to stop, but I have to mention some of his other achievements. Given the effective role or effective effect, impact of your companies in development, and exploring investment areas which were untapped, we have received the award of King Abdulaziz, the order of King Abdulaziz of excellent businessman, and the order of independence from the Republic of the Sudan, and the order of independence first class from Morocco. Order of Independence, first class, Tunisia. In addition to other many other awards and certificates, and honorary degrees of doctorate. And other awards from Malaysia and many others. Lastly, Sheikh Saleh is also a member of many councils, and such as the Council of the Trustees of Arab Thinking, King Abdulaziz Foundation for sponsoring talented people. Also a member of the International Academy for Information Sciences, Arab Academy for
financial and banking
standards. كل هذه موجودة
the Permanent Council of the Islamic Solidarity Fund
لمن أراد أن يستقي من المنبع.
Chairing the General Council for Islamic Banks and Institutions and the Islamic Chamber for Commerce and Industry and Agriculture and the Jeddah Chamber of Commerce and the Council of Saudi Chambers. And the Council of Saudi Chambers and the Union of GCC Chambers and many others. He also owns different banks and financial companies. Please welcome Sheikh Saleh Kamil. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thanks and praise be to Allah who created us to worship Him. And who made everything that is useful to people stems from his worship. So he made the activities of construction on earth
عندما قال الله سبحانه وتعالى رفعنا بعضهم فوق بعض من درجات
promoting growth and prosperity on earth also
ما رفعني درجة لأني أحسن
could be considered as
رفعني درجة
worship
عشان يسخرني للناس
meaning of this word
أوجد عمل لهم
which also is really strange I'd like to say that I have enjoyed during the last 2 days all that I have heard from the different sessions I have benefited and added to my experience many things. As we have said in the opening session remarks that interest in growth comes from the importance of promoting prosperity on earth and paying attention to the youth because employment is one of the noble objectives of our presence in, on this land. Quoting from the Holy Quran, an ayah to support this argument. I am not given a better step or grade, not because I am the best or the better than the others, but to help others, to assist others. So as once I stop from playing this role, there will be no better grade or step factor.
وزير التربية والتعليم الآن
Thereafter,
الذي أتشرف بأن أكون نائبه في هذه المؤسسة
we will come and,
في عام 2003 كان المؤتمر عن التعليم ومخرجاته
the category, the category of ويل لكل همزة لمزة
to every corner and مكر سوق العمل
الذي جمع مالا وعدده who collects wealth and counts it continuously. يحسب أن ماله أخلده. He thinks that his wealth will make him immortal. Our obligations that we have to fulfill in terms of our duty as ordained by Allah are many in terms of available of wealth. They include that you implement what you have been ordained to do, sir, when you have been given this higher rank or this higher grade step. If we understand well the meaning of this word, we would not have the word unemployment originally or initially. However, we have went away from the source. Before delving into what I would like to say, I would like to make a comment on the last session I agree with my brother, Dr. Abdullah, that the problem lies with education. And I'd like to give him a good piece of news that's what he advocated, that education should be for the sake or the purpose of work is a slogan that we have raised at the Institution of Arabic or Arab Thinking, chaired by His Royal Highness Prince Khalid al-Faisal.
والشفافية والعدالة.
Minister of Education now.
وأن نساعد بعضنا بعضا وأن ننفع بعضنا بعضا.
Whom I have the honor to be his deputy in this institution. In 2003, the conference was on education and its outputs. We recommended that the outputs of education should be appropriate for the requirements of labor of the labor market. I hope that Allah will guide him to success in implementing this objective and this vision, which was laid down more than 11 years ago at the said institution. Also, this was also one of the objectives of the Islamic Chamber of Commerce and Industry also in 2002, and it was set out as an objective. You can see the slogan of the Islamic Chamber of Commerce on the paper I'm presenting now. So this project was elaborated jointly by the Islamic Chamber of Commerce and the Institution of Islamic of Arab Thinking and the General Council of Islamic Banks and Financial Institutions and the Council of Saudi Chambers and the Chamber of Jeddah. And this initiative is an embodiment of all the proposals made in this forum. And you may observe that the topic of the forum is growth through youth and International Center for Growth and Operation. Al-Masbaq. Al-Masbaq is the place where transactions are made, or where are deals are made. Transactions in the private sector and some transactions in the public sector are deals. If we find a place to organize these deals in a manner that is accepted by Allah and His Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, first of all, and provide them with all rules of good governance, transparency and justice, and that each one of us help the other, and that each one of us would be beneficial to the other, the result would be great. All problems raised in this forum and all solutions proposed for, during this forum, this initiative took us more than 30 years to develop in all places that I had the chance to go to visit them, alhamdulillah, and this was the outcome of these different experiences. I had the chance also to be the chairman of the Jeddah Chamber of Commerce and the chairman of the Islamic Chamber of Commerce and Industry. We can implement this initiative. It would have not been possible for me to implement this initiative as a businessman, no matter how great were my businesses. So, Al-Masfaq, or the International Center for Growth and Operation, which is summarized or abbreviated as Al-Masfaq is an investment, industrial, agricultural center in all fields of activities. It combines different parties, those parties, each one has his own appellation or attribute, partners of success. Government circles, and then we have opinion and science partners, then we have efforts and capital partners, then comes the system of companies. These are types of partners. If we come to the success partners, who are they? They are the government circles which supervise and give license for all activities at the public, at the private sector, Ministry of Commerce and Industry, the Ministry of Investment, the Ministry of Agriculture, with the Ministry of Tourism. This issue is proposed for all Islamic states. Therefore, we deal with the Ministry of Tourism, as well as the Labor Ministry, the Social Affairs Ministry, the Health Ministry, the Funds for Human Resources, which we have here, and some other countries have similar funds, the municipalities. Adventure capital companies. Also, we have the implementation companies, those who are which are specialized in achieving or implementing a specific piece of work. Then after them, we have the leasing companies, which will help the youth not to build a building for their work. They can rent such buildings. There are people who want to invest their monies in this regard. We can use them. Then we have the operation companies. Then they come to those youth who do not have IDs. We establish groups for them to for the operation companies for all things such as the social interaction. They need not purchase equipment. We rent them for them. There are others who want to invest their monies, which we can use in this regard. We have the operation companies and the youth who have no idea can be distributed into groups for the operation companies for all activities that are known or not known. For example, the social interaction or social media, interaction which are now making billions of dollars around the world. Then we have the support service companies. In large parts of the world, they depend on outsourcing. Why should we do everything from A to Z? If you want to open a restaurant, you don't need to bring an accountant. We have an accounting company of five people, they can take care of your accounts at the restaurant. Why should you have personnel? We have a company which can bring you the labor and train him. Just focus your work on the menu and the kitchen. They should be specialized on their work, in their work. All the support service can bring from outside. The network of the support service can employ millions or millions or thousands of unemployed people who are looking for jobs. I endorse what was said by Dr. Abdullah with regard to the issue of education. I said at the beginning that there are three parties would be the harming them. The second thing is education. The third thing, and maybe the first thing, the businessmen. Do not forget, please, that one day you used to be like them. I did not come from a wealthy house. I was like any other people who wanted to build themselves as businessmen. And it was the grace of Allah that I reached what I am in now. Do not forget where you were and try to make hundreds like you. Take them by the hand. I do not agree with what was said by Dr. Nadia, although I thank her for her enthusiasm and her emotions for her for other women and babies. And, but when she comes and say that we close down the center of Khadija, this is wrong. Dr. Abdullah said that all information are accurate. This piece of information, I'm responsible for it. The center of Sayyidah Khadija is not closed down. It is still exercising its role. If you say, what did the government do? It did a lot of things for us. We used to have education. Did we have education for ladies 40 years ago? We should not forget the merit, but we should call for reforms. As long as there is life, there is a need for reform. So, this is a small comment, a minor comment. Then we have the training and education companies, about which Brother Bagadir asked, what are we doing with those present that available at present? From the Masfaq, we established an academy which trains girls in the area of housekeeping. I do not like to use English terms for which we have equivalents in our rich and very rich language. They also train them for cosmetics and sewing. I'm not saying those works are only for men, for women. The one who created women created men as well. The activities which we have within the Masfaq, each one of you who comes at the reception, you will be asked, what are you coming for? We have all these activities. You specify which activity you want, small or new projects. He will take you to the director of the new projects. You will sit with him, whether your project is small or large. You will sit for 1 hour. You are going to fill in a form together, so that he can understand whether your project has a potential of success or whether it is serious. And then he can determine who is a consultant who can work with you to get the idea to be matured. And he will call him by telephone. And then will fix a rendezvous, an appointment with him for you tomorrow at a specific hour. Then the consultant will come and sit with you, and if he finds that your proposal is okay, he would say that if you have a study, I'll review it for a specific charge, and if you don't have one, I will prepare one for you with a specific charge. If you don't have money, the director of activities can finance us. So the director of activities would come, and if he approves, then he will finance the study. The philosophy behind this is development. No one would bear the risk without this place until this company is established. So if the activities director finances the study, when the director finishes the study within 1 week or 1 month, then the activities director would come, and if they agree to declare it, it will be declared. Specific date, specific place. Those who buy or purchase the study, they will come and meet with the idea owner, the consultant who studied the issue, and the director of activities and a lawyer. They will sit together, all of them, for one day, for one week. They will establish a company. If the company is established, the lawyer is going to register that. Then we put the capital in the banks, take the deposit slip, go to the Ministry of Trade and Commerce to approve it. Then they have the investment commission. If there is a foreigner among them, then they have a public notary, and we have a company established. The consultant estimated that the project would cost 100 million Saudi riyals, 50 million as capital and 50 million as finance. So we have banks here who have finance. You can go and agree with them. You have investment funds. You can go and agree with them. Do not go out without establishing the company. And you have your partners and the required finance. So far, we have 12 activities, new projects, insolvent projects, which can be rehabilitated or restructured, successful projects which could be expanded. This is the first type. Then comes the activity related to the commodities. Many young people do not want to be employed. Each one can do what he was created for. We can train them, for example, to be merchants. Then we come to the major merchants who import. Do not go to from import to retail, and don't be foreign gangs monopolizing the retail markets. Unfortunately, let us recognize or admit that we all know that covering up corruption is a crime. I don't know how to call it, but against any unemployed Saudi youth, maybe his family was the reason behind that, also the bad education, but there is also the possibility of someone who is covering up corruption. He's bringing 30 to 40 people who are monopolizing the retail market, all the retail market has non-Saudis. We welcome all people. However, the sons and daughters of the country should have the priority. To start with yourself and those who are you are taking care of. Let us train those to be merchants. Then we come to major merchants. They have a ship at the port. Do not tell. Give this guy 10 tons and he will pay the 50,000 for them. If he doesn't have the 50,000, I will guarantee that he will pay in 3 months. He is fearful. He doesn't want to borrow the 50,000. We can pay the 50,000, but we'll have 60% of the profit and you have 40% next time. Half of your profit, you will put it in the deal. If this is repeated 3, 4, 5 times, he will become a merchant. You can proceed depending on Allah. Then we'll deal with another one. After the commodities, which could be imports or could be local industrial commodities, it could be also locally cultivated. Prophet cheating. And he gave the example of selling bad dates. This is the transparency about which now there are books. So we want to lay down the basis of moral economy. I'm not speaking of Islamic economy. All faiths advocate morals. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that he came to make the good morals complete. He did not say that I came to show you the good morals. He did not do injustice for the people before Islam. So Islam does not support injustice against anyone. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came as a mercy to the world, entire world, not only Muslims, to the entire world, indeed. So he came as a mercy to the entire world. So we should fully understand our religion. After the community related activities, we have the real estate activities. Therefore, we brought the Ministry of Municipalities. May Allah reward Dr. Hani Abu Ras, who visited us. He came with his senior advisors or assistants. They understood what method we are following. How can we facilitate the works of the people? How can and what measures were taken by the government to facilitate that? And we have also benefited from the public transport, transportation roads. These are pioneering experiences. We here have many things. I did not start with the first one, which is the small and micro enterprises. All these prices, all these enterprises, our responsibility ends once the company is established, with exception with the small and micro enterprises, because their problem is not related to financing only. Many of us cite the Chinese proverb, give me the fish and do not give me the fish, but teach me how to fish. We have the noble prophet's saying, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when someone came to him and asked him to give him money, he said, no, go and see what you have at home. He went and brought something, said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, who is going to purchase it or buy it? So he brought him the finance. Then he gave him the money and asked him to go and bring an axe. He taught him. So he started with the finance. So we want finance that is likely to let the one who seeks it to feel responsible. Because if you give him easy finance, he can go and not come back. So the boy or the girl should feel that he is responsible and that he should pay back this money again. Unfortunately, we have focused on financing in our entire region. Muhammad Yunus, who was awarded the Nobel Prize, he took it because he was inspired to have a cheap follow-up method. And he succeeded. Each society should look for the follow-up method and the training method that is appropriate for his for their society. I have delayed the explanation of the small enterprises because all these activities, once the company is established, we do not see them with exception with the small and medium enterprises, because we are responsible to train them and to provide them with the training and to follow them. Up to his success. In fact, Jeddah Chamber of Commerce was pioneering before I came to it in terms of the small and micro enterprises. They're telling me that the time is over. Thank you all. I just wanted to say that what was said, and we have benefited from that, and this experience will be launched inshallah this year, and I believe that it will change many of our societies in the entire region with the help of Allah. Thank you for your good for listening. Sheikh Saleh, of course, you have taught us in the forum to stick to our time. Therefore, I hope that you will apologize us. We have small amendment in today's agenda items, but there's one major point which was mentioned by Sheikh Saleh that should not forget the merit, but we should call for reforms.